parsha, we learn about the story of Noah and how he took refuge in the ark, the Teva, when God brought forward the Mabul, the flood on the world, and unfortunately destroyed the civilization of the world, and he had to go ahead and restart from scratch. So here we have Noah descending from the ark, the Teva, and it's just him and his wife and his, you know, three sons and their wives, just a few people, and they have to go ahead and start society anew. Think about what that entailed. And the Torah tells us about one of the first things that Noah did. He went ahead and planted a vineyard, and he went ahead and had some wine afterwards. The way the Torah addresses this is, "Vayochel Noach ish ha'adam." Noach made himself chulin. He made himself mundane with this act, because he should have gone ahead, as Rashi points out, and been involved with something else. And this has always troubled me, because if you think about Noach and his life and the stress that he had, and not only building the ark, but being in the ark for a year, and all the responsibilities that he had in taking care of all the animals and wildlife and fowl, and he gets off into the new world, and all he wants to have is a glass of wine. You know, is this the worst thing in the world? He wants to have a glass of wine after being cooped up in this rocky boat for an entire year, and coming back and seeing that civilization has basically been destroyed. He just wants a glass of wine. Is this the worst thing in the world? And I really think what this teaches us is the importance of priorities. There's nothing wrong with a glass of wine. In fact, wine in Judaism is a celebrated item many times in our happiest events, under the chuppah or other happy events. We make kiddush on the Shabbos with a glass of wine. But Noach, after he went ahead and got down from the ark, this should have been the time to set his priorities straight. This should have been a time that now we have a new opportunity with a new building of society to go ahead and say, let's go ahead and place the most important things first. A glass of wine, should that have been the most important thing? And that's why we went ahead and had a critique of Noach. I think in our lives, we have to go ahead and remember the importance of priorities. So folks, as we start this year, and we go ahead and look upon the horizon, we see so many different needs, so many different challenges, so many different tasks that we have to do. Let's remember the story of Noach and his glass of wine, and remember the importance of setting your priorities straight. Have a wonderful Shabbos.